The reviews are in, and the world's first test tube burger isn't bad. All it might need is a little ketchup.
It wasn't a ringing endorsement, though. It was described as being a bit dry. Of course, it hasn't got the fat of a normal beef burger.
That's, of course, because it isn't a real burger. Grown in a laboratory with stem cells from dead cattle, the burger is the result of years of research from Dutch scientists.
It's made up from 3,000 tiny strips of meat grown from stem cells, and it's said to be gray with a slippery texture similar to squid or scallops.
What it lacks in flavor, the in vitro burger makes up for in that it's fat-free. Both a food critic and a food scientist were on hand to put its taste to the test.
There's quite some intense taste. It's close to meat. It's not that juicy, but the consistency is perfect.
The absence is, I feel like, the fat, but the bite, you know, feels like, you know, a conventional hamburger.
Still, the scientists are touting it as a safe and more sustainable way to consume meat. According to the World Health Organization, the global demand for meat will double by 2050. But it could be a long way off before you hear anyone asking, do you want fries with that in vitro burger? Making just one took 8 weeks to grow and cost scientists $384,000. For Newsy, I'm Elizabeth Hagedorn.